Don't throw away that old PC, because I'm going to show you how I turned this one into my dream arcade cabinet. Let's get to it. If you're like me, being a kid growing up in the 80s and 90s, then you know how amazing arcades were back then. I've always dreamed of having an arcade cabinet of my own, and I was finally able to make it happen. I knew I wanted a cabinet that ran multiple games, because I've loved so many arcade games over the years, and picking just one game wouldn't be enough. So I searched around on the internet some, and many of the cabinets I was considering were really expensive, and the one that fit my needs the best was about $3,000, and I really didn't want to spend that much. Then I stumbled upon RecRoomMasters.com and found some great looking arcade cabinets optimized to work with a PC. These cabinets looked amazing and cost just under $900, so that sounded much better to me. A little backtracking here, this wasn't my first time putting together an arcade machine because I had built a couple bar top units for my family, and I was proud to be able to do it, but I am not handy by any stretch of the imagination, and I don't have the power tools to cut a full-size cabinet and do all the T-molding and everything myself, so this was definitely the best option for me, and trust me, these cabinets have amazing quality. You can ask for custom designs to be on the cabinets as well, but I wanted a bunch of classic arcade logos on my cabinet, and luckily Rec Room Masters already had that option. I had to call their customer service a couple times to make sure we were on the same page, but you immediately were connected with a friendly staff member who helped a first timer through this process flawlessly. The cabinet I ended up purchasing was the 32-inch Pro Upright Extension Arcade Machine Emulator Edition. The cabinet comes completely unassembled, but it can easily be put together with two people. Most of the assembly can be performed with an Allen wrench, and they even supply you with a backlight for your arcade header. I was blown away by the professional quality of the decals and that orange peel type texture you expect from an arcade cabinet. There's even a secret drawer to hide away your PC's keyboard and mouse to not take away from the arcade experience. My old PC was actually an HP All-in-One I bought back in 2009, and it initially ran Windows Vista, so it doesn't take a powerful computer to run this machine at all. Since the monitor was built in, it was pretty easy to just put the PC in place and cover it with the provided plexiglass bezel that came with the cabinet. I then just marked the outside edges of the monitor on the plexiglass, and I used black spray paint to cover all the dead space around the screen. Now that we have the PC in place, I'm going to show you what I believe is the most incredible part of this machine. It's the Extension Emulator Edition controller. It features two 8-way joysticks, a 3-inch trackball, and 10 LED menu buttons. It's PC and Mac compatible and pre-configured to work with MAME straight out of the box. And what tops it off is that it's just a simple USB connection to your computer and you're done. When I built the other cabinets, I had to connect endless amounts of wires to both the joysticks and the motherboards for the controllers before even thinking of connecting it to the PC. Literally, this controller is plug and play and it's near perfect. You don't even have to access your old keyboard and mouse to navigate your PC either, because the trackball acts as a mouse and the left and right mouse functions each have an LED button on this controller, and they work perfectly. I'm not going to get into the actual ROMs and emulator process in this video, but I will tell you the front end that I used to make the arcade machine function like a real arcade unit and not look like you're playing on a PC. If you're not familiar with the term front end, this is a program that organizes and allows you to select your games on your computer in a way that makes it look like you're using an attractive select screen instead of pointing and clicking with your mouse all the time. There are many front ends out there, but the one I use I feel is the most intuitive and user-friendly for people taking on this task for the first time. The front end I use is M-Galaxy. It allows me to have nice attract modes and previews of my games without me having to spend a ton of time programming it all. With M-Galaxy, you can easily manage all of your emulators for any gaming systems like MAME, NES, Genesis, Laserdisc, etc. You have so many options with this front end, and it's easy to go in and make changes as needed. Now, before you say it, I do agree that Hyperspin is a front end that looks better, and if you're up to the task of putting the time in to make it look great, then you're awesome. I personally just had trouble figuring it out, but I was able to configure M-Galaxy pretty easily with a few Google searches and YouTube tutorials. I'll put a link for M-Galaxy in the description below. Once you get M-Galaxy configured, then you're all set to go. Now you can go back and visit all those great classics anytime you want. If this is your first time here at our channel and love retro gaming, tutorials, let's plays, boss battles, and family gaming for all generations, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and click that bell for notifications every time we post a new video. Give us a big thumbs up if this video inspires you to finally build that arcade cabinet you've wanted to build since you were a kid. Let me know in the comments below if you're going to build one, and I want to know what your favorite classic arcade games are. Until next time, guys, G3 out.